Biology Chapter 15 Biodiversity and Conservation of Class 12th. Topics covered in this chapter are Level of Biodiversity, Number of Species on Earth, Pattern of Biodiversity, Loss of Biodiversity, Biodiversity Conservation. The term biodiversity was popularized by the sociobiologist Edward Wilson to describe the combined diversity at all the levels of biological organization. In our biosphere, immense diversity exists at all levels for biological organization, ranging from macromolecules within cells to biomes. The most important level of biodiversity are genetic diversity, species diversity, and ecological diversity. Genetic diversity. Genetic diversity is the variation in the genes and their alleles in the same species. For example, the medicinal plant Rauxia vomitoria, growing in different Himalayan ranges, shows genetic variation in terms of potency and concentration of the active chemical respirin that the plant produces. There are more than 50,000 genetically different strains of rice and 1,000 varieties of mango in India. Topics covered in this chapter are Level of Biodiversity, Number of Species on Earth, Pattern of Biodiversity, Loss of Biodiversity, Biodiversity Conservation. Ecological Diversity. It is the variety in the type of ecosystem in a region. For example, India with its deserts, rainforest, mangroves, coral reef, wetland, estuaries, and alpine meadows has a greater ecosystem diversity than Scandinavian countries like Norway. It has taken millions of years of evolution to develop this rich diversity in nature. We could lose all that wealth is less than 2 centuries if the present rate of species loss continue. Biodiversity and its conservation are now vital environmental issue for our survival and well-being of this planet. Number of species on Earth, global species diversity. According to IUCN 2004, the total number of plants and animal species described so far is slightly more than 1.5 million, but we have no clear idea about the total number of species that exist on Earth. A conservative and scientifically sound estimate has been made by Robert May, puts the global species diversity at about 7 million. More than 70% of all the species recorded are animals, while plants including algae, fungi, bryophyte, gymnosperms and angiosperms account for about 22%. Among animals, more than 70% are insects. Among animals, insects are most species group. That is, out of every 10 animals, 7 are insects. Number of fungi species is more than the combined total of species of fishes, amphibians, reptiles and mammals. Animals are more diverse than plants, including plantae and fungi. Biodiversity in India. India has only 2.4% of the world's land area, but has 8.1% global species biodiversity. Hence, India is one of the 12 mega diversity countries of world. In India, there are about 45,000 species of plants and twice as many of animals. Many more species are yet to be discovered and named. If we apply Robert May's global estimate, then only 22% of the total species have been recorded so far. Biologists are not sure about total number of prokaryotic species because conventional taxonomic methods are not suitable for identifying microbial species. In laboratory, many species cannot be cultured. Biologists are not sure about those species. If we accept biochemical or molecular criteria for deciding a species, the number might run into millions. Latitudinal gradient. In general, species diversity decrease as we move away from the equator towards the poles. With very few exceptional, tropics latitude range of 23.5 degree north to 23.5 degree south harbor more species than temperate or polar areas. Examples for latitudinal gradient. Number of bird species. Colombia, located near the equator, has nearly 14,000 species of birds, while New York at 41 degree north has 105 species and Greenland at 71 degree north only 56 species. Tropical forest region like Ecuador has up to 10 times of vascular plant species as compared to a temperate forest region like Midwest of USA. Tropical forest region like Ecuador has up to 10 times of vascular species as compared to the temperate forest region like the Midwest of the USA. India, with much of its land area in the tropical latitude, has more than 1200 species of birds. The Amazon rainforest in South America has the greatest biodiversity on the earth. It harbors about 40,000 species of plants, 125,000 species of insects, 3,000 species of fishes, 1,300 of birds, 427 of mammals, 427 of amphibians, 378 of reptiles, and more than 125,000 of vertebrates. Pattern of biodiversity latitudinal gradient. Reason for highest biodiversity. Species richness in the tropic regions are: tropic have more evolutionary time, relatively constant environment, less seasonal. They receive more solar energy, which contribute to greater productivity. Species area relationship. German naturalist and geographer Alexander von Humboldt made pioneer and extensive exploration in the wilderness of South American jungles. He observed that within a region, species richness increases with increasing exposure area, but only up to a limit. The relation between species richness and area for a wide variety of taxa, that is angiosperm plants, birds, bats, fish, water, is found to be a rectangular hyperbola. On the logarithmic scale, the relationship is a straight line and is described by the equation log S is equal to log C plus Z log A, where S is equal to species richness, A is equal to area, C is equal to y-intercept, Z is equal to slope of line, regressive coefficient. Value of Z lies in the range of 0.1 to 0.2, regardless of the taxonomic group or the region. The species area relationship among very large areas like the entire continent has much steeper slope of the line. Z values in the range of 0.6 to 1.2. The Z value for the frugivorous fruit-eating birds and mammals in the tropic forest is found to be 1.15. Importance of species diversity. Ecologists believe that communities with more species tend to be more stable than those with less species. According to David Tillman, plots with more species shows less year-to-year variation in total biomass. He has also done some ecological experiments using outdoor plots. Increase diversity contribution to high productivity. It is essential for ecosystem health and survival of human race. River pot hypothesis. It was given by Stanford ecologist Paul H. Eldridge to explain the importance of species diversity to the ecosystem. It states that if an aeroplane equivalent to an ecosystem has thousands of river equivalent to species. In an aeroplane ecosystem, all parts are joined together using many rivets, that is species. If passenger pop a rivet extinct of the species, it may not affect flight safety functioning of the ecosystem. But as more and more rivets are removed, the plane becomes dangerous weakly. Loss of rivets on the wings, key species that drive major ecosystem functions, is more dangerous to flight safety than loss of a few rivets on the seats and windows inside the plane. This analogy is comparable to the functioning of an ecosystem. Thank you.